Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video today I'm going to discuss about some around 80 to 82 questions of the interview of VMware. And before going further guys, I would like to request all of you, whoever is watching this video or listening this video, please take a notebook, pen, paper, pencil and make a note what you are going to learn from this video, because I will tell you one thing where we make mistakes. We do watch lots of videos, but we are not able to, at the end of watching video, we may not be able to understand what we have learned. Okay, so the basic concept of learning is you should make a note, you should understand what you have understood from that particular topic, because for human it is little difficult to remember each and everything. Okay, so learning is like taking a key point from the entire story. This is the way you can learn something, because generally we don't do this thing, okay, and we forget what we have learned from the time we spent. So very simple, take a notebook, make a point for whatever you want. Okay, very simple. And the thing is, like, there can be, like, you know, very big explanation of some certain questions, so you can note down only important point what you have understood. That is the only thing if you can do, you can understand each and everything. There is no difficulty in understanding anything in the world, but you should follow the proper way. I hope ki I have given you, like, you know, very very simple way to learn and understand thing. So guys, VMware, as you know, if you are working in VMware or if you are going for VMware, then it is a, you know, you can say service for making virtualization or using virtualization. So I have uploaded couple of questions, couple of videos on installation and configuration of VMware 6.7, and if you go to my channel, you can find it out from there. Now we will understand, we will prepare for interview. So guys, very simple, we are going to learn about VMware. So what is VMware? First of all, you should understand. Okay, so that is the very very basic questions anybody can ask. And if you are going for Windows administrator, they will ask what is Windows, and if you are going for network, they will ask what is network. If you are going for any software, they will ask what is software. So here first question comes, that is, what is VMware, or what do you mean by VMware? So you can have lots of, you know, explanation, lots of answer for this. So VMware is, you know, one of the, you can say it is a software, and VMware is the leader in providing different software and application for virtualization. So VMware is a company, okay, and a part of Dell now. So they provide lots of application and software for virtualization, and these can be, like, you know, server level. Basically these are divided in two part, one is server application and second one is desktop application. Same concept here, why we use VMware, it is useful for running multiple application and operating system on single computer, and is used to get high productivity from very few servers. So meaning is very simple, I will show you one thing here. I have VMware, okay. VMware is also a software of virtualization. So let me run here, I will show you. I'm using this Workstation Pro. So I can run multiple operating system, this is what, as you can see here, if I go to this, as you can see here, so I installed one Active Directory, one BC, vCenter Server, EXI, and some other Windows 7 client, Windows Server 2016. I have installed all here, and I can run all of them together. So I switched on two operating system here, two virtual machine, and this is ESXi 6.7. And this is how we can use multiple operating system. Now you can install multiple application also on this Active Directory here, other thing, and this is ESXi. So this is what VMware provides. It is an application software which provide platform to install or run multiple application and operating system on a single computer. So this I will make it a little simple. For example, I have this one machine, physical machine, where I have installed Windows 7. This is my Windows 7, okay, and I have 24 GB RAM here, and I'm running this VMware workstation on my physical machine. So on this physical machine only we are going to install multiple operating system with the help of this VMware workstation, okay. So VMware workstation is also a product of VMware. So very simple, you can explain like this. Now you can note down what you understood, because I believe all three points may not be, for a couple of users may not be easy to remember, but you can remember a couple of things. Like you can note down a couple of things. It is even you can answer this much. It is useful for running multiple application and operating system on single computer, and is used to get high productivity from very few servers. Now what you can do, you can purchase only one big server and you can run multiple operating system. So you do not need to purchase three hardware server, okay, because you are doing the same from one machine only if you are using this VMware workstation. So this is how it can give you same sort of productivity with less cost, okay. Little bit be some amount you need to spend to purchase good hardware as per the requirement, but still if you need to purchase three server 1 lakh each, so you need to spend 3 lakh rupees one. But if you spend 1.5 lakh and if you purchase good hardware, like you take 128 GB RAM, 64 GB RAM and good processor, so you can do the same work from one server only by using this VMware workstation or any other software like this you can run. Now we will move to next question, and this is what one more thing, it can also speed up the new application deployment by simplifying IT management. Now we'll move for the next question. What is virtualization and what are its type? So there are there are a couple of types of virtualization. So virtualization is nothing virtually we are dividing one physical machine in multiple machine. Just now I showed you we have one physical machine, that is my HP machine, this HP machine, okay, where I have deployed this Windows 7. On Windows 7 I have created multiple virtual machine, so that is called virtualization, okay. And as per requirement I gave 4 GB to this, and I gave couple of if you go to this setting you can see how much RAM I gave to this. I gave some around 10 GB RAM, as you can see here, and this machine also you can check how much RAM I gave. Like this we can manage easily 4 GB RAM, 2 processor, 60 GB hard disk. So this is called virtualization. Now there are mainly four type of virtualization. One is presentation virtualization, second one is storage, third one is application, and next one is network virtualization. Very simple question. Next we will move to the third question. What is hypervisor? Very simple, very basic question. So guys, hypervisor is nothing but it is also a program, you can say, or process or software basically. So you can install this on one physical machine, okay. Physical machine once that machine should have an operating system on that you can install this. So I will make it easy for you. This is what, once again I'm giving you example, I have one physical machine, this is my physical machine. So on one physical machine I have a processor, okay, and it is a, you can say, memory, video card, disk and network. This is Windows operating system installed, just like this machine. This is my physical machine, okay. Windows 7 is installed. Now I am going to install one program that is called this ESXi, this one, with the help of VMware workstation. So if I want to use multiple client operating system, Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10 or any server, I will use this, okay, this ESXi, that is called hypervisor for real virtualization. How? Now I will show you. Same thing here, virtualizing the computer and adding virtual machines, a system before virtualization. So it is a physical machine. Now if I am going to make virtualization, so I installed one hypervisor, that is ESXi. Just now I showed you here, this is ESXi host, okay, and that is called hypervisor. Now with the help of this, I will install multiple virtual machines: Windows, Linux, Windows, Solaris. That is coming on this host only, that is called host. This one is called host, ESXi. Okay, now this is called complete virtualization, a single system now hosting additional virtual machines. So this is my physical machine, physical computer, there I deployed this 6 virtual machines with the help of this hypervisor. And hypervisor is like your this machine, this one. So basically, hypervisor is a process of segmenting the OS and application of a computer through underlying physical hardware. It drives the concept of virtualization by allowing the physical host machine to act as a guest for practical usage of computing resources such as network, bandwidth, memory and all. So we will assign certain memory to this hypervisor. Just now I showed you here, I gave 4 GB RAM as of now, so I can change it, and 2 processor you can see here. So we can change this at the time of installation. So hypervisor is nothing but it is a platform, or it is a process where we can create multiple virtual machine. Next question, guys, what is VMware vSphere? So VMware vSphere is nothing but it is a package, okay. So VMware Suite is globally recognized as a VMware vSphere, and it comprises of virtualization management, other interface layers. So it is a package basically, okay. And the VMware vSphere is a commercial name for the VMware Suite basically. So you can say it is a box, okay. It has lots of services, lots of functions and all. And the essential core component of VMware vSphere are ESXi server and vCenter server. So for installation of this, you can subscribe channel and you can go through the channel. Definitely you will learn lots of things from that. So two very important, I will explain you what is vCenter server and ESXi server in the coming of slides. Now vCenter, what is vCenter? So guys, vCenter is nothing but, you know, it is again a software of virtualization or concept of virtualization, but this is basically used for management. Management means what? Central management. For example, you have deployed one ESXi or okay, not one, you have deployed 1, 2, 3, 4, so you have 5 machine on this one host, 10 machine here and 15 machine here, so total you got 30 machine. So it is difficult to manage all those 30 client machines one by one. So you can use vCenter server. vCenter server will give you a single point for management of VMware infrastructure, okay. That is why it is called vCenter server. And like, you know, vCenter can accommodate thousands of ESXi hosts within the inventory, which enable you to handle multiple ESXi hosts. So just like this, for example, I created only one ESXi here, so I can have 10-15 as per the requirement, and I can manage this from vCenter server. So I just lost one hard disk where I had deployed this and not getting time to reinstall, but you can go through channel and search the video vCenter server installation configuration. Definitely you can understand, because I had created lots of ESXi host and virtual machines. Now it is a central point for configuring, provisioning and managing virtual IT infrastructure. So guys, you just make a point only, okay. I'm giving you 4 points here, so you can note down only one, like the central point for configuration, configuring, provisioning and managing virtual IT environment. That is also sufficient to answer this question, what is vCenter. Okay, now if you want to understand, you want to learn, you can have lots of points from here. Like, it provides essential data center service such as access control, performance monitor and alarm management and all. Now we will move to the next question. What are the benefits of VMware? Okay, so basically there are a couple of benefit. The very simple one is, like, you know, you can run multiple operating system and application on single computer. Just like I showed you here, I have one physical machine here, this one, and I'm running multiple operating system here. These three just now I showed you. For example, if you run this also, you can run this also. But it is also depend on the physical capacity of your physical machine, because it will be taking resources from that machine only. Now consolidate hardware to get vastly higher productivity from few server, save more than 50% of total cost. That's like, yes, I told you, you need three server, so you can use this VMware, and if three server cost is 3 lakh, you can spend 1.5 lakh only and you can use VMware. These are the basic benefits of VMware. It simplifies IT management and speed up the deployment of new applications. Now you can see here, this is what a single virtual machine hosting additional virtual machine, and you can deploy lots of applications as per the requirement. Here if you want some other, here if you want some other. Okay, these are the benefits. Now what is vCenter agent? So guys, an agent which enable communication between vCenter and ESX server is called agent. vCenter agent, it is installed on EXI server. So like anything, if you are using WSOSE or any antivirus, like Symantec endpoint protection. So this is, for example, if you have this server and you are installing on this client machine, so one client agent will be installed here. So that agent will take care of communication between server and this client machine. So that is same thing applied to here also. If you have vCenter server and ESXi server, so to make communication between both the servers, you need one vCenter agent. Next question, what are the type of hypervisor? So basically there are two type of hypervisor. One is called like type A or type 1. So basically you can deploy this directly on physical server. You are purchasing one hardware and you can install on this. But if you are going for, that is also called bare metal. And the second one is hosted hypervisor. Hosted hypervisor is also known as type 2 or B type. So for this you need to have operating system installed. Meaning is simple, for example, and OS based system. Okay, so I will explain you here. For example, this is my Active Directory. So here I have installed server, which server it is. It should be 2016. So you need one operating system already installed on one machine, and then you can install vCenter server. That is called second type 2 or hosted. Okay, because you need one host for installation of this hypervisor. So if I show you here, I have a couple of virtual images. So this image. So if I want to install type 2, then I will have to use this image and I will have to install this image on this server. That is called hosted. For hosting you need one installed operating system. Very simple. Okay, and if you want type A, directly you can install just like this. You just need one physical machine. Now we'll move to the next question. What is cloud suite? So guys, by name itself you can answer this question. Cloud suites is nothing but it is a package. Once again you can say, like, okay, vCloud suite is used to combine the multiple component of VMware to give the capability of cloud infrastructure complete set in a single package. Okay, so it is a package, like you can say. Once again, it is a box where it should have lots of capability to make complete and successful infra on cloud, including, I will tell you, disaster recovery. It should be capable of disaster recovery. Next one is virtualization, application management. Okay, these are the packages, or you can say component of this suite basically. or in these all should be included in this package, data center service, etc. Okay, so these are the common services it should include in this vCloud Suite. Next, we will move to the next question. What are the different stages available in vCloud Suite? So guys, there are stages. We need storage, different storage. So we have data protection, storage, DRS, application, high availability storage, vMotion. Okay, so these are the available storage availability on vCloud. Next, what is NFS? So NFS is nothing but it is a network file system. Basically is a file sharing protocol that uses communication bridge between ESXi host and network attached storage devices over TCP/IP. So basically it is used for for data storage only. And if you are using ESXi host and you have NAS like device, so to access data between NAS and ESXi host, you need to have this protocol enabled in your TCP network. And it can hold ISO image, templates, virtual machine file and other dates. So this is what I will show you here. Okay, simple example here, VMware VSphere data center physical topology. So this example, for example, you got this is your ESXi virtual machine, one host, you got server group, you can create like this, and this is your fiber channel, storage vCenter server you have installed here, client is there, okay, web client terminal, and these are the server group, all hosts are kept here. You can say it is SAN, or you can say here NAS also you can consider. So this is what you need to have, and this to make communication between this NFS is required. It should be enabled, it should be functioning properly, because you have one vCenter server here, okay, and you created a couple of virtual machine with the help of this ESXi. So and you want to keep here, no, you kept one machine here, you kept one here, and you kept one here. Now you are using vCenter server, you want to enable and anything like vMotion or anything between these two, so there should be communication, proper communication. So for that NFS is very important. Now DRM, next question, what is RDM stands for ROM device mapping. So basically is a mapping file located in VMS volume and act as a proxy for the raw physical storage devices, and it allows the virtual machine to read and write from the storage, and it also contain metadata to manage and redirect this to physical devices. By using RDM we can use vMotion file system, and even we can add raw LUNs to the virtual machine. LUNs is nothing but physical drives. I had created one video while I uploaded configuration of VMware, how to create iSCSI LUNs or physical drives in network. Even I had shared in one video like how we can use OpenFiler server for storage of virtual machine. So if you want, you can go through the video, you can search, definitely you will get it. So it is just is a mapping file located in VMFS virtual machine file system volume and act as a proxy for raw physical storage devices. Next question, what are the basic differences between VMware and hypervisor, Hyper-V? So guys, it is MS basically, it comes along with Windows Server, and we can have separate also, and VMware vSphere. So there are lots of features you can see here, like if we talk about terminology of virtual machines. So it is distributed switch we need to use in VMware vSphere, but here we have virtual switches, okay, and if we want to create like virtual machine, then we need to have distributed, either distributed or standard switch. But if we are creating virtual machine on Hyper-V, then we need to create internal, external or private virtual switch here. And here DRS, distribution resource scheduler, is there. And here performance and resource optimization option is there. We can use this separated power management, dynamic optimization, core parking, and VMware tool also, integration component also. So you can find couple of things from here. Okay, now storage. So raw device mapping in virtual VMware, just now I told you about it. It is a mapping of file located in volume and act as a proxy and physical storage devices. So that is also available here. And pass through in mapping, extended volume grow, expand disk, we can expand storage in vMotion, quick storage migration, resource management, fault tolerance is there, application high availability is there, fault tolerance is there, no fault tolerance here on this. Okay, and high availability, yes, failover clustering we can use here in hypervisor, Hyper-V as compared to VMware vSphere. Now next question is, you can find lots of other differences in Google and all if you go. Next question, what is .vmdk file? Just now I show you one thing here, we show it is vmfs volume. Okay, now we are going to see new thing here, that is called .vmdk file. So what it is? So guys, this isn't the file containing the raw data, first thing you should remember. Next one, it is a virtual machine disk. Instead, it is the disk descriptor file that describes the size and geometry of the virtual disk file. Okay, next one, this file is in text format and contain the name of the hyphen flat dot vmdk file for which it is associated with, and also the hard drive adapter type, drive sectors, heads and cylinders, etc. It will contain this much information, and one of these file will exist for each virtual hard drive that is assigned to your virtual machine, one of these file. So you should remember at least one thing from here. Anyone, whichever is good, you can note down and you can remember, because the explanation or answer of this question is little critical. Next one, what is VMware vMotion and what are its requirements? So again guys, these are the questions where you need to give little bit more attention. You need to note down only important things, because again I'm going to tell you lots of things in this answer. Like VMware vMotion enables live migration of running virtual machine from one physical server to another with zero downtime. So that is called VMware vMotion. Okay, we are moving virtual machine from one server to another server without any downtime, zero downtime. And vMotion lets you, what happens here, automatically optimize and allocate entire pools of resources for maximum hardware utilization and perform hardware maintenance without any scheduled downtime, proactively migrate virtual machine away from failing or underperforming servers. Yes, before now these are the requirement. Okay, these are the, you can say, advantages of vMotion. And what we have understood about vMotion is, like, it is a migration of running virtual machine from one server to another server. You need to take care of couple of things before you can initiate vMotion. First of all, each host must be correctly licensed for vMotion. License should be there. Each host must share storage requirement, vMotion migration, the virtual machine from one host to another, which is only possible with both the hosts are sharing common storage or to any storage accessible by both the resource or target host. So same thing, I will take you back. It should be complete setup. Okay, so for example, this is your one storage, this is your second storage. So for example, if you are, I'm just giving you, this is one host. Okay, from here you are keeping or you are moving to this one from here. So it these both should be accessible from here also and here. That is the concept of it. This is the basic requirement. Okay, and there are some more thing like a shared storage can be fiber channel or SAN or NAS. If you use vMotion to migrate virtual machine with raw RDM file, make sure to maintain consistent this thing logical drives. Each host must meet the networking requirement. VM kernel should be enabled, dedicated like at least 1 GB adapter for vMotion, and couple of things you can check from here. I'm not going through one by one or all the points. So you need to take care of all those things before you migrate virtual machine from one server to another server. Now another very simple question, very basic question: clone versus template in VMware, or what is the difference between cloning or template? So guys, again, note down only important things from here. As you can see, I told you here, I'm going to tell you here about clone. Okay, so in simple word, clone is nothing but it is a copy of virtual machine. This much is also sufficient to answer this question, but if you want to understand in detail, so let me give you one by one here. First thing, cannot restore the clone virtual machine. If you have cloned any virtual machine, you cannot restore to virtual machine. Next, clone of virtual machine also be created while the virtual machine is switched on. Cloning can be done in two ways. One is full clone, second one is linked clone. A full type of clone is an independent copy of virtual machine that share nothing with the parent virtual machine after the cloning operation. Ongoing operation of full clone is entirely separate from the parent virtual machine. And if you talk about a linked clone, is a copy of virtual machine that share virtual machine with the parent virtual machine in an ongoing manner. Okay, so guys, you can go through the rest of points here because it is consuming lots of time. So it is just a copy of virtual machine. Next, what is template? I will tell you in next slide. That is what I'm telling you. Just note down the important things only, but I don't know whether you are doing or not. So now I will tell about what is template. So template is nothing but it is also a copy of virtual machine, but it is a master copy. Okay, there is a difference between a copy and one master copy. Master copy is like, if you want to do anything changes, you can use this master copy. Okay, that is the difference between clone and template. So template will be your master copy. A master copy or baseline image of virtual machine that shall be used to create many clones. With the help of this template, you can create multiple clones. Now you should read couple of more things here. Template cannot be powered on or edited, and are more difficult to alter than ordinary virtual machine. You can convert the template back to virtual machine in order to update the base template with the latest release patches and update, and to install upgrade any software, and again convert back to template to be used for future deployment of virtual machine with the latest patches. So two things here you should remember, like go back, can't restore the cloned virtual machine, okay, this one, and here the template cannot be powered on or edited. But if you want to edit, you will have to convert it. You need to convert this first to your virtual machine, then you can edit, you can update it, and you can once again create it as a template so that you can use it for future requirement. Okay, that is the difference. Convert virtual machine to template can't be performed when virtual machine is powered on. So for this, only clone to virtual machine can be performed and the virtual machine is powered on. So if your machine is on, you can create a clone, but you cannot create template. And like a template offer a more secure way to preserving virtual machine configuration that you want to deploy many times. So while you are cloning a virtual machine or deploying a virtual machine by a template, the resulting clone virtual machine will be independent of ongoing template or virtual machine. So you can just note down this line only: a master copy or baseline image of a virtual machine that shall be used to create many virtual machines that is sufficient to answer. These are the additional information, and here also you can say a copy of virtual machine. Next question: what is the difference between thick provision, lazy zeroed, and thick provision, eager zeroed? So guys, here again there are lots of points about it. If we talk about thick provision, lazy zeroed, so what will happen here? Create a virtual machine disk in a default thick format, okay, and space required for virtual machine disk is allocated when virtual machine is created. I'm talking about this lazy. Data remaining on the physical device is not erased during creation but is zeroed out on demand at a later time on the first write from the virtual machine. So guys, you can go through, I'm not telling you much about it, and you cannot convert flat disk to a thin disk. And if I tell you a little bit about this thick provision, eager zeroed, a type of thick virtual disk that support clustering features such as fault tolerance, space required for virtual machine disk allocated at creation time, and like in contrast to the flat format, the data remaining in the physical drive is zeroed out when the virtual machine is created. It might take much longer to create disk in this format than create other type of disk. Here one thing you should remember, like using the default flat virtual disk format does not zero out, eliminating possibility of recovering deleted file or restoring old data that might be present in the allocated file space. So you can read this carefully. Basically this is just for information, but sometime they may ask this question. Next, what is a snapshot? So you are getting one more thing, very very common: clone, template, and snapshot. So guys, a snapshot is also a also a process of creating image only or copy basically, but it will create at a certain point of time. This is the difference between clone, template, and snapshot. A snapshot is a point in time image of virtual guest operating system, and the snapshot contains an image of the virtual disk, RAM, and devices at the time the snapshot was taken, when you captured it. With the snapshot you can return the virtual machine to that point in time whenever you choose. For example, if I am creating any snapshot at 5:53 p.m. and after half an hour that machine got any problem, you can restore that machine with the help of this snapshot, but that will give you information from 3:53 only, or till 3:53 p.m. only, okay. And you can take a snapshot of your virtual machine no matter what guest operating system you have, and the snapshot functionality can be used for future, like performing image level backup or image level backup of the virtual machine without even shutting down them. What is VDI? Next question is VDI. VDI stands for Virtual Desktop Infrastructure, where end user physical computer like desktop or laptop are virtualized, due to which VMware described VDI as delivering desktop from the data center. And once VDI has used, the end user connect to their laptop using device called thin client. So here guys, you will have one server, okay, this is server here, all application will be installed and you will be connected here. This is your end laptop or desktop, and you will be using applications from this, that is called thin client. This one, all each and everything will be coming from here. And you can use one another application like, you know, VMware Horizon View installed on the desktop or mobile devices. Now next question, what is VMware High Availability? Very important question. So guys, VMware High Availability, that is HA, which work on a host level and is configured on cluster. So basically it is a cluster, okay, adding multiple host as a single. It is called clustering. So a cluster configured with high availability will migrate and restart all the virtual machine running under the host in case any host level failure. So the meaning is very simple. If you are creating you got two host here, okay, this is one ESXi host and this is two. If any virtual machine is failed to restart, facing any problem, and not able to restart, machine will be So guys, high availability is a concept of clustering. Basically, as you can see here, okay, I created this is this example. This is a one cluster here. I have three machine. Okay, on three machine, I have created couple of virtual machines. This is what, if one host server is down, so virtual machine will be restarted on this. And it will, I mean, all virtual machine will get will be functioning from other host, but this will restart. Okay, so there will be little bit downtime, and VMware High Availability continuously monitor all ESXi server host and cluster. So if you have created any cluster, so it will be monitored. For this, it will use one heartbeat. Okay, it will run continuously whether this server is up or not, like that. If it is failed, so it will restart, and till that time there will be little downtime, and after some time that will be up. Or you have to figure out what is the issue for this downtime of the server. Each server sends the heartbeat to each other server in the cluster at 5 seconds interval. So this will give its information to this and this to this, like I'm okay, I'm working fine, like that. If this is failed, this will not send any update to this. Okay, and high availability initiate the failover action of restarting all affected virtual machine on another host. So this virtual machine which is kept here will be running from here in that condition. So there is a downtime in high availability. That is the concept of it. You will get availability of your virtual machine, but there will be little downtime because virtual machine will restart. Okay, next, what is the difference between VMware High Availability and vMotion? So very simple guys, high availability is nothing but it is a process of providing continuous service of virtual machines, but in case of any virtual machine is down, any host is down, it will run from other host, but there will be some downtime. And VMware vMotion is a service, or is a process of moving or migrating virtual machine from one server to another server. So like as you can see here, VMware High Availability is used in the event when any one of the host inside the cluster fails, then all the virtual machine running under it are restarted on different host in the same cluster. And high availability is completely depend on vMotion to migrate VMS to different host. So vMotion is just used for migration purpose between multiple host. vMotion also has the capability of migrating any virtual machine without interrupting. Next question, this is what you can see. I'm talking about, this is high availability. All virtual machines will be restarted from here if this host is down, and this is called vMotion. We are migrating virtual machine from this ESXi host to another host. Okay, very simple. Next question, what is storage vMotion? So there is a difference in vMotion and storage vMotion. So you should focus here only. This vMotion, in this vMotion, like storage, we are talking about a storage here. Okay, now so you have to focus only single thing, like storage vMotion. We are talking about a storage only. So storage vMotion is similar to vMotion. Both are similar in the sense that something related to virtual machine is moved, and there is no downtime to virtual machine guest or end user. However, with SVMotion, that is called storage vMotion, and VM guest stays on the server that is resides on, but the virtual chest for the VM is what moves. So meaning is very simple. I'm not reading anything. I'm not giving you much anything what is written here. I told you about vMotion. vMotion is used to move or migrate one virtual machine, one server to another server. What happens in storage? In this storage, only virtual machine files will be migrating from one data center to another or one server to another server. That is the difference between vMotion and storage vMotion. So in storage vMotion, only files will be moving. Okay, disk, virtual disk. That is the difference. I'm not going with any other point here. So as you can see here, this is virtual disk dot amp dot vmdk file moving from one server to another server. That is called storage vMotion or one data storage to another data store. Now guys, what is VMware DRS and how does it work? DRS is nothing but distributed resource scheduler. Okay, so I will tell you in very simple, or let me show you if I have taken any example here. This is like, you know, simple image. You can read lots of things from here, like here DRS, distributed resource scheduler, which dynamically balance resources across various host under cluster or resource pool. So basically it is a resource pool or cluster, you can say. In this you will have lots of host, or it will be a cluster. Okay, so VMware DRS allow user to define the rules and policy. We can create couple of rules and policies, how virtual machines share resources and how these resources are prioritizing among multiple virtual machines. So these are the policy we can create here. Second thing, now resources are allocated to the virtual machine by either migrating it to another server with more available resources or by making one more space for it on the same server by migrating another virtual machine to different server. So the meaning is very simple. You have two server. Okay, if you need to install one more machine here and it is running out of capacity, so you can find out. I have one virtual machine which is not in use, so I can migrate that machine to this server. This is how I can do manual work. But if you are using DRS, that is called distributed resource scheduler, you can create policy, and if it is enabled on all the inside this cluster, you can say, or wherever it is we need to enable, so automatically it will take care of that portion. For example, you can assign a virtual machine to cluster and DRS finds an appropriate host on which to run the virtual machine. So the meaning is very simple. For example, you have three physical server and you have installed ESXi host. Okay, and here for example, again same concept, if this server is not capable to take care of any one of these three virtual machine, or any virtual machine is finding difficulty in executing or functioning, so what will happen? This distributed resource scheduler will see that scenario, that will understand what is happening here. So it will identify any other host or any other physical, any other ESXi host, which host has this capability to run this virtual machine on the behalf of this server 1. If server 2 is capable, server 3 is capable, means this host, that machine will be executed or will be functioning from this from that host only, which is capable. That is the basic function of distributed resource scheduler, to keep monitoring, to identify resource allocation, which machine is not able to, or which server is not able to execute or function, and which server is capable. Okay, like that. That is the concept of DRS, distributed resource scheduler. You can read couple of more things from here. Now next question, we will move to next question. So just now I reached to 24th question. It has 82 questions, or guys, I may upload in couple of part. So in this I will try to cover let's see 40 questions. What is VMware fault tolerance? I spoke about high availability, DRS, vMotion, storage vMotion. Now we will understand fault tolerance. So guys, fault tolerance is also a process or service of providing continuous availability of application running in virtual machine, okay, and preventing downtime. There should not be any downtime, there should not be any data loss in event of server failure. So if your server is fail, virtual machine should run continuously, application should run continuously, there should not be any data loss. So this is what we can use as fault tolerance, and this is the, you know, advantage of using fault tolerance. So VMware fault tolerance, when enabled for virtual machine, create a live shadow. So let me see if I have taken any image here. No, I have not taken, so I will tell you. So what happens here, for example, you have one host here, and this is your second host, okay. You created one VM here and you enabled one fault tolerance on this virtual machine. So for example, you are creating this machine on this E1, so automatically it will create one more image here, that is called your secondary image on second ESXi. That is the concept, that is called shadow instance of the primary running on another physical server. So you have one server here and second server here, and the two instances are kept in virtual lockstep with each other using VMware VLOC technology. So that technology is called VLOC state technology. The two virtual machine play the same exact as a, I mean, both at both the place that virtual machine remain as it is. If you are installing anything on this virtual machine, same will be replicated to here. That is the concept, okay. Now what will happen? VMware fault tolerance on ESXi host platform provide continuous availability by protecting the primary virtual machine with secondary virtual machine that run on simultaneously second host, just now I told you. And any input we are giving, that will be reflecting on the secondary machine, okay. For example, if you are clicking any mouse or giving any keystroke, are recorded on the primary virtual machine and replayed on secondary virtual machine, same thing will be recorded there, because the secondary virtual machine is running simultaneously with the primary virtual machine. It can take over at any point without service interruption or loss of data. That is why we use fault tolerance. Fault tolerance will be enabled on virtual machine, high availability will be enabled on ESXi host, that will be a cluster, inside cluster, okay. That is the difference. So in interview they will ask one question, what is the difference between fault tolerance and high availability? So in high availability there will be a restart, there will be a downtime, but in fault tolerance there is no downtime, there is no restart, continuous service. Next question, we will move to the next question, 25th. What happen if vCenter server is offline when failover event occurs? Now failover is happening and your vCenter server, from there you will manage your virtual IT infra, so that is down. So what will happen? So guys, here when fault tolerance is configured for virtual machine, vCenter server need not to be online for fault tolerance to work, okay. Even if vCenter server is offline, failover still occurs from primary to secondary virtual machine. So meaning is very simple, you have one this is host, okay, and you created two, this is your, you have two host, and this is, you created one virtual machine here that is replicating here secondary, and you have one vCenter server. vCenter is server is for management. Even if this vCenter server is down, still that failover will happen. If this that virtual machine is not running from here, that secondary will take over at any time, okay. So there is no impact of, even if vCenter server is down, in failover. Now next question, what is the difference between type A and type 2 hypervisor? So again, I told you already about type 1. Type 1 is like, you know, bare metal or embedded or native hypervisor. You can install this on physical hardware. Okay, it works directly on hardware and it is completely dependent on operating system, independent of operating system. Here we don't require the operating system. And the hypervisor is small, as its main task is sharing and managing hardware resources between different operating system. And a major advantage of this type of you can run like a major advantage is that any problem in one virtual machine will not impact other virtual machine, okay, because these will be separate. Example, VMware ESXi server, hypervisor, Citrix, Zen server. Now what will happen in hypervisor 2, type 2 or type B? Because if we are going to install hypervisor type 2, we need operating system, we need Windows server. On Windows server we will install just like MS Office. So what will happen if my Windows Server 2016 is down? My entire IT infrastructure, virtual infra will be down. That is the disadvantage. And as I told you earlier, this is also known as hosted hypervisor. In this case, the hypervisor is installed on operating system and then supports other operating system above it. It is completely dependent on hosting operating system. Okay, while this base operating system is down, all will be down, like VMware workstation, like this. If my Windows 7 is down, this Windows 7 is down, that is on my physical machine, I won't be able to access these many machines because my VMware workstation will be off. Okay, that is the difference. Now we'll move to the next question. How does VSphere high availability work? So even I hope you have already understood, when configure multiple host for high availability cluster, a single host is automatically elected as a master host. So automatically there will be a election of a master host in high availability. The master host communicate with vCenter server and monitor the state of all the protected virtual machine and slave host, I mean other host here. When you add a host to VSphere high availability cluster, an agent is uploaded to the host and configured to communicate with other agent in the cluster. Now very simple, if you have two host here, and if you are adding any one more host here and you are using vCenter server, so vCenter server will detect this. You will have to add this on your vCenter server and it will update the information about it, and it will then keep monitoring all three hosts in high availability inside that cluster. What are the monitoring methods used for high availability, VSphere high availability? So guys, here the master and slave host are two type of monitoring: data store heartbeat, network heartbeat. These are the technology to be used for monitoring by vCenter. So vCenter server will be using data store heartbeat, network heartbeat for the monitoring high availability between all three hosts. Now what are the role of master host in high availability? So master role is like primary, okay, that will be responsible for all the updates and all inside that high availability or cluster. Monitoring the state of slave host means other secondary host. Okay, second, if the slave host failed or become unreachable, the master host identify which virtual machine need to be restarted. Okay, for example, this is your master and this is your slave. This is here. Let me take a paint better to explain. For example, what should I take here? Okay, this same thing. This is your master, this is your slave. okay, any machine is running from this one, any VM, and that is down. So it will keep monitoring the state of slave. This is master. So now it will check here which machine need to be executed from this. So it will execute from here at that point of failure. That is the role of primary role of master host in high availability. Monitoring the power state of all protected virtual machine. If virtual machine fail, the host, the master host ensure that is that it is restarted. If any failure is there, it will check and restart as per the requirement. Next question. And again, managing the list of cluster host and protected virtual machine. Acting as vCenter server management interface to the cluster and reporting the cluster health state. These are the primary role of master host. Now guys, how is master host elected in vSphere high availability environment? So you can see here, like, you know, when vSphere high availability is enabled for cluster, all active hosts participate in an election of master host, and the host that mount the greatest number of database has the advantage in its election. So if you have four database on one host, that will be your master. Okay, if you have five database in one host, that will be your master. That is the basic concept of election of master host. Only one master host typically exists per cluster and all other hosts are slave. If the master host fails, it's shut down or put in standby mode or is removed from the cluster, a new election is held. So if that is down, so that will be in standby mode or will be removed from cluster, and new election will happen. So again, they will check which host is having more data stores, and that will be your host, master host in that high availability. Now you got one situation. If vCenter server goes down with a situation that it was pre-configured with vSphere high availability and DRS, so after power down, will high availability and DRS perform their task? That is the situation. You got one live environment here. So first thing, high availability is not vCenter server dependent. Okay, first thing you should remember, for high availability we do not need vCenter server is just for management purpose. Now for its operation, and high availability is configured, it install on each host. Does it so here, like, high availability is enabled on host, so vCenter is not important in this case. Also, high availability doesn't use vMotion, it just restart the virtual machines into another host in any case of host failure. That is the concept of high availability. Now what will happen to DRS, distributed resource scheduler, in case of vCenter server is down? So guys, further vSphere DRS is very much dependent on vCenter server, as it uses vMotion for its action for live migration. So in case vCenter is down, vCenter server is down, DRS will be impacted. In this condition, vMotion will not work, leading to failure DRS. Okay, so you should have the basic idea in case of vCenter server is down, what will work, what not will work. Now next question is, what is FT logging traffic? So guys, FTP logging is one of the options in VM kernel port setting, which is more or less the same as enabling vMotion option in the VM, in the kernel port basically. So it is a monitoring of communication between host basically. Now what is the use of VMware tools? So VMware tools is very important okay, let me show you. For example, here only I can show you. So guys, I have this virtual machine, okay. This virtual machine, just let me try to log in. So as you can see here, I'm showing you here. If you click here and you can see install VMware tools, okay. So you can use this. You'll have to wait. So as you can see here, just now I installed one operating system, okay, and finding like this, it is coming black this side, because I didn't set anything. But if I install this VMware tool, it will adjust automatically. So I'm just installing you, okay, install it, and you will see automatically this will be adjusted, couple of things, graphics and all. So that is the use of using virtual tools. We will learn about it. So I'm just showing you here how it works, so it will be easy for you to remember, okay. So just now I mounted that software, it is installing. Once it is installed, you will see difference here automatically. We will not do anything. So you can see, like, you know, it is helpful in case of low video resolution, inadequate color depth, incorrect display, network speed, restricted movement of the mouse and all. So we face you face lots of problem in case of in the absence of this VMware tool. If you install this, you can you will not face such problems. So sometimes this mouse doesn't move properly, okay. So if you install this, all problem will be gone. And inability of to copy and paste the large and drag and drop files. So I will tell you one more thing. For example, if you are installing two Windows operating system, okay, this India ID and this WinVC. So if you want to copy something from here, initially you won't be able to copy and paste on another server, okay, here. If you are copying from here, but if you install on both the server, you can copy and paste easily. So as of now, it is not running, else I would have told you. So same thing you can do. You can, here I have already installed. So if I log in, I will get proper resolution. I do not need to set anything. Resolution will be okay. Everything will be okay. And here, once it is done, it is getting installed. And this is the stuff is coming. So see, it is coming complete. I do not need to install here, okay, because it is already installed. That is the use of using VMware tool. It fixed my resolution problem, and once it is done here, you will see automatically this will be fixed. Synchronize the time in the guest operating system with time on the host. So these are the, you know, users of VMware tools. Next, what is host isolation in VMware high availability? Okay, isolation in VMware high availability. In VMware high availability, it has a mechanism to detect a host isolated from the rest of host in a cluster. Again, cluster is a group of multiple hosts. So what will happen? It is a detection of isolated host. In simple word, it uses a heartbeat to communicate another host in cluster. So if you have four host or three host, so there will be a heartbeat for communication between all three host. Now what will happen when the ESXi host loses its ability to connect with another host in a cluster through heartbeat? Then ESXi host will be considered as a host isolation. For example, this first host is down due to some unwanted reason and it is not able to communicate with others. So this host A will be considered as isolated host. This is what I'm talking about. If this is down, so this will be your isolated host. So let me show you this installation is done or not. So the guys, as you can see here, this is finished and you need to restart. So I'm not restarting, but it fixed that that black color, that resolution problem, okay. So this is how that tools is important or can help in many ways. Now we will move, what is the difference between VMware high availability and VMware fault tolerance? So I'm not reading anything. Once again, I'm telling you, if there is a high availability, it will be enabled on host base, and there will be downtime in high availability to restart the impacted virtual machine from another host. But in case of VMware fault tolerance, there is no downtime, and it will be enabled on virtual machine. There will not be any downtime. That is the difference between fault tolerance and high availability. It will give you continuous service of application. Now moving to the next question. Again, if you want to read, you can read, like you know, it will create primary and secondary kind of things. Now next question, 35th question. What are the new feature included in ESXi hypervisor enhancement? So there are lots of things got enhanced, like, you know, hot plug and play PCI SSD devices, solid state disk. Next, support for reliable memory technology, and enhancement for CPU C states, that is also known as a power process, is used to provide additional power saving. And you can read couple of more things from here. Next question, what is fault tolerant logging? So guys, the communication between two ESXi hosts is known as fault logging when fault tolerance is configured between them. Explain VSS. What is VSS? VSS stands for virtual standard. Okay, it is responsible for communication of virtual machines hosted on single physical host. So the meaning is very simple. Once again, I will tell you. For example, this is my physical machine. Once again, this is physical machine. I have installed here one VMware workstation. On this virtual workstation, I installed three virtual machines. So communication between all three virtual machines should happen, and that is done by VSS only. Virtual standard is responsible for communication of virtual machine hosted on a single physical machine or host. Next question, guys. It automatically detect a virtual machine which want to communicate with other virtual machine on the same physical server. And this is what I was talking about. This is one physical machine. You have created multiple virtual machine here, and this, it will detect which machine want to communicate with which one. Next question, guys. Explain some feature in VMware tools. So it offers simple wizard for setting configuration, web browser interface. You get all those things. Easy maintenance of virtual machines. And next question, we will see what is, define the term vkernel. So VMware kernel is a proprietary kernel of VMware. It needs an operating system to boot and manage the kernels, and a virtualization interface in between ESXi host and virtual machine that stores virtual machine is called VMware kernel. So this line is important. A virtualization interface in VMware ESXi host or in between ESXi host and virtual machine that stores virtual machines is called VM kernel. Okay, so it is an interface or platform in between. In between is important. ESXi host and virtual machine. It allocates all ESXi host resources to virtual machines such as CPU, memory, storage, etc. It can also control the special service like fault tolerance, vMotion, traffic migration management, NFS, and iSCSI. So you can define it by yourself, a virtualization interface or platform in between virtual machine host and ESXi host and virtual machine can communicate with each other, can be stored, that is called VM kernel. Next question, what is the purpose of using virtual machine port group? So the purpose of virtual machine port group is very simple. If you virtual machine port group helps for virtual machine communication. If you have five machine in one group, so those machine will be communicating in single group only. Okay. Give three reason for using VMware workstation. So guys, you can tell three reason. I'm using VMware Workstation, this one. What is the reason? What is the advantage? Simple. Enable the user to run more than one operating system in single. Saves the existing OS configuration in the form of virtual machine. Allow you to work on different OS without switching them between them. Yes. Meaning is very simple. I'm running three operating system. One is VMware ESXiX here. I'm switching very easily. I'm going wherever I want to go. It will help me to create virtual machine here. So let me show you. This is virtual machine created at India AD. Similarly, I should have other also. So tricks and all I tried. I will show you here. This is also secondary VC machine, and here I should have ESXi. So like this VMware workstation is helpful. Now, what are pluggable devices which can be added while virtual machine is running? So if virtual machine is running like this, you what and all hardware you can add devices. So guys, hard disk and NIC while virtual machine is running, you can add. That is called hot swapping devices also, or hot swapping process. What is the use of Promiscuous mode? Oh my god, it is hard to pronounce for me. So this mode is useful when you want to run virtual machine with network sniffer help you to capture packet of the network. Moreover, if the this mode is set to accept, all communication is visible to all the virtual machines. So it is used for monitoring, basically capturing the traffic, packets and all. What is cold and hot migration? So guys, very simple. When you migrate powered off or suspended, it is known as cold. When you migrate your machine running, which is power on, that is called hot migration. Next question. What is primary use of port group in data center virtualization? So guys, you can separate the network traffic by using port group like fault tolerance, management, traffic, vMotion, etc. So fault tolerance traffic will go separately, management traffic will go separately, vMotion traffic will go separately. There will not be conjunction. Now, what is virtual desktop infrastructure, VDI? So once again, like I already spoke about, you will have one server, centralized server, okay, and it is also known as server based computing, as it is the variation on the client server computing model. You will be using third party tools to access resources from that server. Explain the importance of snapshot and VMware. Basic question. So guys, once again, very simple advantage of or importance of snapshot. A VMware snapshot is a copy of virtual machine disk file which is used to restore virtual machine to a specific point of time. Okay, that is the most important advantage of using a snapshot. What is VVOL? So guys, virtual volume, known as VVOL, is a new virtual machine disk management feature concept introduced in 6.0 vSphere. It enables array based operation at the virtual disk level. It is automatically created when virtual machine disk is created in virtual environment. Management feature, okay, it was came in 6.0. Next question. Explain cluster in virtual or VMware. So guys, cluster is like, you know, cluster in virtual machine is a logical group or grouping of multiple ESXi host. It allows you to add, delete host from cluster. It also provide a feature like high availability DRS on cluster. Now, disadvantage of VMware virtualization platform. So it requires considerable investment to buy resources. High-end server need, which increases cost, different technologies, are required for its implementation. So guys, here I'm covering 50 questions only, and there will be 32 more questions. So I will be covering those 32 more questions in my second video, and I hope this video will be informative. And I'm sure if you note down the important points, definitely you can crack VMware interview without any problem, without any big challenge. There will be some 32 questions, I'm telling you, but very important questions. So if you want to crack, just make a note, understand basic things. Don't try to remember or, you know, do by heart all the points, just basic things. That is the way of learning. That is the you know, easy way to remember what we have learned. Just make a note down. And if you try, like, I will watch this video, I will watch this video and I can be hero in VMware and I can crack interview. So that is not possible. That is my guarantee. Only making points can help you to learn and understand the things. So guys, we'll meet you in next video. Till then, bye bye. Thanks for watching for this video, and if it is helpful, you know what you have to do. You have to just like, subscribe, comment and share this video. So wait for my next video. Till then, bye bye.